Pray for your local ecologist, because we are kind of going through it right now. Stop me if you've heard this one, but wolves got reintroduced to Yellowstone and it saved the ecosystem. You've probably heard people like me or other researchers talk about this, use it as an example of ecology in effect. It's probably the most well-known ecology theory of the modern era, and it kind of just got the rug pulled out from underneath it. If you haven't heard the theory before or the science behind it, this is the simplistic version. Predators eat grazers, which eat grass. And so, predators indirectly have a benefit for grasses since they're killing off the grazers. And up until recently, it was never better represented than in the Yellowstone wolf reintroduction. I'm gonna try to explain what's going on in Yellowstone in the simplest terms. Basically, this was Yellowstone before humans. It was pristine and perfect, and you had all sorts of animals, but the only ones that we care about are wolves, elk, beavers, and willow trees. Now, over the course of several decades, we drive wolves out of the ecosystem, along with most major predators. Now, what happens when wolves are out of the ecosystem? Well, elk explode, and they overgraze everything. Small bushes, eaten. Growing trees, eaten. And everything gets converted to fast-growing grassland, since those are the only things that can survive this elk explosion. Now, since the 1990s, we thought that the way to fix this would just be to bring the wolf back. Simply bringing the wolf back would kill all the elk, and then we would return to our beautiful natural ecosystem. But what's actually happened is we brought the wolf back, but it stayed grasslands. There's even other major predators that are also eating elk. Elk have been in control for a while because of this, but it's still grasses. What happened to the willows? Why didn't the willows come back? Well, all of that was sought to be answered in this paper that came out January 30th. This is groundbreaking research, and it's already making waves in the ecology community. To understand what's going on to this paper, which is very wordy, but has been explained by some incredible creators on here who I will link, let's go back to the moments when the wolves were gone before the ecosystem slid into grasslands. Well, with no wolves, it's just beavers, elk, and willows. And we need to take a closer look at the system that we haven't been talking about, the beavers and the willows. Beavers use willows, along with some other trees, but primarily willows, as their main food source, and they also use it to make dams out of. However, when they're cutting down these willow trees, which have to be large adult willow trees, they're not killing them. They're actually leaving enough tree for them to become tiny little baby willow trees that then grow back into adult willow trees. However, with the elk population exploding due to the absence of wolves, they start overgrazing those baby willow trees, and it leaves no adult willow trees to return into the system as food sources for the beavers. So now we have no adult willow trees and no beavers. Just all these baby willow trees, which leads us to elk explosion and grasslands again. We already know this story. So then it really begs the question, why did wolf reintroduction not bring back adult willow trees? They never truly returned in the way that we expected them to. It remained grassland and baby willow trees. Well, that has to do with where the willow tree likes to grow. It's not grasslands, it's riparian environments or semi-aquatic areas near rivers and things like that, which are also where you find beavers. You know why? Because beavers like to build dams, which really support these riparian environments. It's a positive feedback loop. Beaver dams are essential for creating the habitat for willows to regrow into tall adult trees, but willow trees are needed for beavers to build those dams. And by removing all this, the whole system just fell apart and it can't return just by reintroducing wolves. So now we're left with, yay, wolves are back and elk are in control, but the willow tree system isn't returning, the beavers aren't returning in the way that we expect, and so it's still grassland. And there's no easy solution because ecology is never simple.